In this video, I will show you how to use the SQ4 business module to monetize strategies created in StrategyQuant. There are basically two ways to monetize strategies. First, you can sell them directly on the MQL5 market. Or second, you can sell them directly to users within your own communities. So let's get right to it. Before you create a project in StrategyQuant for business itself, you need to create a logo that you will use within the strategy. What I did was I used ChatGPT and had an image generated for me. The prompt was easy. Please generate some logos in square format about gold and AI trading robots. There should be gold as the brick with a combination of the latest AI trends. ChatGPT gave me these two options to choose from. I like this one logo better, so I downloaded it and I will use it in the project. Now I'm in StrategyQuant and let's open a project. To use this feature, you need StrategyQuant Ultimate. If you don't have it, you can find the link in the video description. So let's open a new project and I name it AI Gold Robot. I have to choose a strategy and then also some copyright. And in my case, I'm going to choose our official website. Then I set the version to 1.0. It's important not to use a comma here, but to really write a period. Then I copy the comment and write a short description here. For example, AI trading breakout setup, just like this. That's enough for a short description. Let's click on the logo. Choose the one you want, and it has been added. Here, I recommend hiding the parameters. This is because the parameters are optimized, and for some user who will be using it, it can be confusing. Therefore, I recommend not using the external parameters. And I only want to set up trading options. What can be helpful is the magic number, then the other parameters, like trading within a time frame, then the other parameters, like here, it is always necessary to take into account what is used in the strategy. Because, for example, the times within the change of trading hours, for the parameters within the time frame, I recommend leaving the parameters adjustable. This is precisely because of changes in trading hours and the change between summer and winter time. This is so that user can change it in some way. Let's move on. We will definitely leave exit on Friday, exit end of range. That's not used here, so I can turn it off. If the strategy uses these parameters, I recommend leaving them. But if the strategy doesn't use them, it's completely unnecessary. Order type to exit, we will turn that off too. Max distance, I will definitely leave. Even if it's not used, some brokers may have it. Max trades per day, we can also leave it on. Minimum, maximum, stop loss, profit target is not used here, so I'll turn it off. And the tick size sometimes needs to be set manually. It depends on the broker's quotation. So I would definitely leave it here. I open bar delay just in case there is a problem around midnight. Expiration time, I will turn this on. And if you turn this one on, the backtest in MetaTrader 4 or 5 will be much faster. Now, one important note, before you start compiling strategies together, you need to select the path where you have your MetaTrader installation saved. And there must be a meta editor in this directory. This is because StrategyQuant uses direct compilation and you will get the resulting EX4 or 5 file directly from MetaTrader without the source code. So now I will set everything up and you don't have to write a single line of code. Click on save and save the path. You can add various external indicators to resources, but only those that are not already included. However, if you use any external indicators that are not part of the standard installation but are imported into StrategyQuant, you need to copy those indicators here to custom indicators, MetaTrader 4 or 5, and the indicators folder. All indicators that are copied here and are also used in the strategy will be automatically compiled with the resulting strategy and will be included. So then there is no need to do anything else. However, as I mentioned, custom resources do not need to be used unless you want an external indicator to be part of the build. Let's move on to the last step, where we will explain the individual restrictions and the resulting build. I will name the resulting project AI Gold Robot. The first step is used to export strategies for MQL market. This option does not limit the resulting strategy in any way. MQL market rules state that we should not upload strategies that have any limitations, even for the free version. Therefore, for MQL market, you need to select this option. The other options are more for cases where you sell strategies directly and you need to deal with different situations. For example, you want to sell strategies directly to a user and the user wants to try the strategy on a demo account first. So you check this option and the resulting postfix will be a dash demo and the strategy cannot be deployed on a real account, only on demo accounts. Then we can lock the strategy to a fixed lot size. This is, again, for cases where the user wants to try out the strategy with a minimum position and you can limit the strategy to trade, for example, a maximum lot size of 0.01. However, if you do this, I recommend turning off the magic number here so that it cannot be edited in the settings, because then the user could run the strategy multiple times just with a different magic number. So if you do this, the comment will be replaced. We can now export this and then limit the strategy to a certain date. For example, you can give the user permission to try the strategy, but it will only be valid until a certain day you choose. Or you can rent the strategy for 1 year, for example. And this way you ensure that the strategy will expire after a certain time. Furthermore, you can enable the strategy only until a certain date and for demo purposes, which means that the strategy will only be valid for a demo account and again until a certain day. Or you can combine various options and lock the strategy to an account number, account name or account number, or set it to demo only. But I'm not going to set that option right now. And here I will select the platforms. And now all the builds will start at once. We are mainly interested in the unlocked version. So let's open the folder with the output and we can see that all the EX5 files have been compiled here and we can upload this resulting strategy directly to the NQL5 market. If we were to send these locked files to someone, we would send the specific file that is locked, for example, on fixed size or demo. And that was all for creating the project. And now let's show you how to apply the strategy to the NQL5 market. Here I'm in our company account where we have some strategies uploaded to the NQL market. And let's create a product. I click on market, click on my products, and click on add product. Here I write down AI Gold Robot. Select experts, account type hedge, specify that it's a trend, and here we could set the price for unlimited use, or we could also rent the strategy, but for simplicity I will leave the strategy as free, and click on add accept condition. Now I can copy the description from another product, so I don't have to write it all out now. So I copy the entire description and I just edit that it's gold based on breakout and pending orders are in fixed pips. Here I refer to specific backtests. I recommend doing those specific backtests as a part of the description so that you can do backtests like the ones that you can see here. I recommend either using Canva or some other graphic editor to highlight specific parameters for the given strategies and actually show some advantages of the strategy and results. But be careful that MQL5 market currently prohibits making promises from various challenges or giving results from third-party platforms such as MyFXBooks or various prop trading challenge certificates. In short, these reports are prohibited there, so I will just download it here, make some adjustment, and I will not upload the strategy in full for now. However, this way I would create a description of what is still important here so that the settings are also correctly described. So I again choose AI Gold Robot here. And basically all the parameters should match what we are allowed to use in the strategy. So I will just edit this here, for example. I can put there IC markets and EST plus 7 time zone. And I delete the note that doesn't belong here and save the description. I can upload a video here and it will link to YouTube. I'm not going to put here a video for this purpose, so I will just upload some kind of screenshot. This is how we upload a screenshot, and now we will upload the binary file itself. I will copy it from the output directory. It will be gold unlocked. So I select the file and save it. Now the automated MQL market test will start, but we are still missing the logo. It has been uploaded. And this way, I have my strategy ready for publication. I will just click on publish. This method may be interesting for someone who wants to further monetize the strategies created in StrategyQuant without a single line of code. And that's all for today's video. If you have any questions, please write them in the comments and I will see you in the next video.